So in that graph, you see the volatility in the spot market of SAP taken from the stochastic vol model, and we compare that to the priced in at the money vol and priced in out of the money vol. So you see that on average, already just looking at the picture, yeah, they share some common movement, which I haven't yet further analyzed, but I can see they are not completely independent of each other. Yeah, here they all go down and then they all reverse again. They all tend to spike here, although the option market spikes more. Now, the second you see is the green line is most often, but not always, below the blue and the orange. Yeah, so the option implied vol tends to be higher. That's a fact, and here it's confirmed in the data set. The out of the money orange is usually the highest. It's usually always above blue and above green. Okay. And once when I showed you that the GARCH, the SVM, and R square implied vol forecasts give you different estimates, one student asked, now which one to use? And I said, there is no rule of thumb. Yeah, like you do that. One has to think about what's for the problem at hand the most accurate measure. I cited some research which used value at risk forecasts to validate whether or not a specific vol estimate is accurate. And the key new point I think for you was I said, let's wait a little bit until we come to option markets. Because in options, you get real-time forecasts. Just want to reiterate, because we did not use any time series information to back out this orange point here. The green we did, right? I just wonder why is green so low? If I want to analyze that, I really need to dig and put some work and make the hands dirty, because it's just an in-sample estimate, the entire green curve. If I change the length of the sample, that vol estimate might also change, right? It's a backward-looking estimator, so it uses past information. Persistence of the HT kicks in. So if H is very persistent, then the green line cannot respond to sudden shocks. It always needs some time to catch up. The orange and blue is different, right? If the market suddenly says, I want out of the money put options no matter what. What we see is here, it just spikes right now. But the information is in the data right now. And I highlighted also, I mentioned it once or twice in the past classes, that research shows that these option implied vols are really good predictors of realized vol. And given what I've said today, it should not come as a surprise that that is high quality information, green, the orange and the blue. But like what happened here in 2000, in 2015, 16? It's in the middle, right in the middle. When I look at the SAP return, okay, that's not much what I see. But I see also these option returns. There was something going on. Yeah, so I mean, I would have to zoom in here to see something happened in the underlying, yes or no. But that thing seems to be might be driven by an increase in volatility for some reason. So now, interesting to connect it back to fundamentals than to business fundamentals. Really try to understand for one exercise, for one example, what happened to SAP in this period. Okay. For the moment, we just take it as data evidence. And what I now do is I compute what's called the variance risk premium. So the